In this video, I'm going to show you some new features in Brave browser that you can try. If you haven't watched my previous video, please watch it for the full Brave setup. So first, go to Settings, Privacy and Security, and then WebRTC settings. In my last video, I asked you to select default public interface only. So please change it with disable non-proxied UDP. Then it will stop the WebRTC leak. Next settings, we will set up the DOH DNS over HTTPS. So to enable that, go down, click on security, and then click with, and then click here and select Cloudflare. If you want another provider, just paste their DOH link here by selecting customs. Next, you can close the browser and open it, then visit browserleaks.com. Click on IP and you see if any your real IP is showing or not. Also, in run DNS leak test, you will only see Cloudflare. Now another new feature in Brave is syncing. To enable that, first go to sync and click on start using syncing. So let's say you would like to sync your desktop browser with a Brave mobile browser. First click on start new sync, then you can select your device type. For me, I will select mobile. Then you can scan this code on your phone or just click on the view sync code to type manually. And if you'd like to sync from another device, then click on I have a sync code and paste the code here. And then click on sync again and then manage the device. So here you can select sync all, or you can choose what features you would like to sync. The next feature is Adblock. Open your browser and type brave/adblock and then select from the list. But remember, turning on too many filters will degrade performance. So I would like to recommend you to select fanboy announce list and fanboy social list and 2-3 other lists based on your country. If you want a custom list, you can add it from here. Now, another feature I want to show you is you can manually disable elements adverts from a website. So for example, I will open a website and then these two things are irrelevant, and although I'm using AdGuard Home and NextDNS, this is still showing me because this banner is loading from the domain itself. So ad blockers cannot hide this advert. So what I'm going to do is go to Brave, right click and select block element. Then I will change my mouse and then I will select this banner and click on create. Next, this box is so ugly and showing me something irrelevant. But the trick is you must move your mouse so that it finds the correct box and the color will be also changed. So I have selected it, then select create. Now I will refresh the page and it will not show me these elements anymore. If you have mistakenly removed an element and the website is not opening properly, open Brave Adblock and then from here remove the elements you created and then it will be fixed. So I have removed it. Now I will refresh it and you can see the banners and elements is back on this website. Another cool feature is the speed reader function. Go to appearance and go down and select speed reader function and enable it. After that, you can visit wired.com and you can see it's loading really fast by removing all the unnecessary elements. If you want the whole website to open, just toggle this off. Brave has launched their own search engine, which is quite powerful comparing to Google. So you can enable that by going to search engine and select Brave. If you find any latest feature that I have missed, please comment down below so other people can find it helpful. Thanks for watching this video.